And now your baby, Youth Ki Awaaz, it's pretty much the mission what we are discussing about.
Right.
It's social media, it is the online space, you're looking into apps. So could you just tell us more about Youth Ki Awaaz and also maybe focus on the feminist or the gender aspects of it?
Right. So Youth Ki Awaaz started in 2008, so it's been nearly 7 years now. Started with a fairly basic idea that young people in India, as you said, I mean, traditional models have kind of failed young people in India, to be very honest. As somebody who's 17, 18, there is no way for a young person to get through to the mainstream media and speak up or to have a policy change in place or to talk to their parents about family decisions. We're always told that, you know, you're young, shut up, focus on your career, focus on your school, studies, education, etc. But the reality is that young people, I mean, when you say that young people are the future of the country, let them decide for themselves. Let them decide their future. That's not what's happening at the moment. That was the kind of status of young people that Youth Ki Awaaz wanted to challenge when it started off. It still runs with that mission. We want to, create a platform for young people to be able to challenge the status quo, to be able to break away from the stereotypes and be vocal about what they think without thinking that how the other person will, how the older generation will think or how the person in front of them will think about them. Over the last 7 years, we've built a niche audience of about 2 million people a month who not just read, but a lot of them also write on the platform. And that's where our own understanding of gender comes in place, because we focus a lot on gender issues. I mean, one of our core focus areas is gender, apart from all the other stuff that we're doing. And with gender, we run with this idea that, we need to make sure that the society is pro-choice and pro-rights. So we kind of propagate and promote that idea of understanding what it means when we talk about things like consent, of understanding what it means when we talk of things like a woman having abortion rights, or when we talk about sexuality education, or we talk about sexual health. What does it really mean to create a society that believes in choice, that believes in rights of people, that believes in the basic human rights? So that's the kind of approach that we take when we cover gender from our perspective.